Well, howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. I got an email and it was great information. And so I wanted to share it with you because there was three tips that were given that had from a new vendor. And what is cool is by reading his email, I can tell the guy is thorough and I can tell he's keeping up with all his stuff. Just every little thing, and being meticulous with his record so that he knows what days are the best and what crowd works best. And that's what we're going to talk about real quick. One of the things that he mentioned, which, was I found interesting, and it's the first time I've ever heard it. And it was the music. He found out, not, and I'm not talking about playing music on your cart, because a lot of vendors do that and may even inject their own commercials. So they have a playlist with their own commercials, which is brilliant. But you'll find more of that on my YouTube page or the learnhotdogs.com blog. But the first one is music. And let me see if I can change this to show this. Music determines money. Okay. Which is crazy to me. I never thought of this. I never even tracked this. He started tracking and he's done a bunch of little events recently. Like he just started. And, he noticed that the crowds where the music, like the music venue, if they have a band there or whatever it is, or a stage, they have, if it's rock music, they tend to do worse. They don't tend to sell as much food. And when it's country, they sell a lot of food, a whole bunch of food. Now, he's got his own theories on this, but he has tracked this on enough venues to know that his rock crowd so far has been lower food sales. I thought that was fantastic information. Never considered tracking that. Like, I've tracked, okay, this venue, the Watermelon Festival, but I didn't track whether when this band is on or this day of music and it's mostly bluegrass or it's mostly rock, does it do better than the other? Thought it was fantastic information, and he's going to use that to determine what events he does going forward and what he preps for and how he prices for those events. So great information, I thought. The other thing, there's actually two other things. Let me do this real quick. His next one was, and now I don't have my notes up here. Bear with me. He did a, menu placement. This was cool as crap to me too. So the second one was menu placement, or what he put on his menu signs. So originally he was doing the hot dog combo meal. So he put the hot dog combo meal up and $6, blah, blah, blah. And he started tweaking it and figuring out what was his highest profitable items, which are like your walking tacos and things like that. He took those and he changed out all his signage and he put big banners up for his chili cheese, whatever, nachos or whatever. So he took his highest gross profiting items and put those front and center on his banners, on his signs, and his sales went through the roof on those items because he was displaying them. One of them, he has a picture, and I'm going to be posting his photos in the blog at learnhotdogs.com. And he probably today sometime, but he has these big signs up, and I'm holding my hands here, but they're gigantic signs with photos of the food and then what it is. And it's a brilliant method for making sure that you capitalize on the most money while you're at an event. So I thought that was a great one. Now, the next one was another good one. I never considered this either. Now, the menu thing I have heard before, okay? You know, putting your highest profitable margin items up front and center. I want to show you, let me take this one off. and we want to put look bigger. Okay, so he's been testing some different things. So what he did is he made his stand and his setup look bigger by going outside of the canopy, the 10 by 10 tent, and making a larger area, or even renting more space for more signs, more coolers, more tables. Not that he needed all that space, but he said that he has noticed that the bigger he sets up, the more customers think, oh, this guy's got everything, we're going there. And it attracts more people, because as your line builds, it attracts more people. They're like, oh, that's the place to be. See the line. And so I thought those three things were fantastic, great ways to improve your business without having to really change anything, and how to kind of have another tip on events. We talk a lot about events on the blog. You know, you can look up all the different things you need to know before you do an event, but never did I consider music of the event to determine the pocket depth of my customer. And I think that was brilliant. And I thank him for sharing. It was it was just brilliant. So anyway, I can tell you who this is. Maybe if I can get it to pull up real quick. Jay Markham. And I've got photos and stuff. He sent me a bunch of pictures and different setups. And I'll show you how he made his stuff look bigger with tents and umbrellas. So he put up a 10 by 10 tent, and then he put up umbrellas on the outside of it. So it made everything look bigger and better, right? And so I just thought it was brilliant strategy. I hope y'all are having a great day. Hope you have a great week. If you're in Vendors United, we got a meeting tonight. Link is in your email. For the private meeting, and I hope y'all have a wonderful day. Talk to you soon.